Hi, my name is Zeen and welcome to the Ultimate Wi-Fi Hacking and Security Series. Today's lecture will be understanding media access control in greater detail. Now, we have been doing penetration testing in many of the corporate companies, and one of the things that we have found is almost all of them had applied MAC filtering on their wireless networks. Now, many of the companies believe that MAC filtering is a secure way to protect their Wi-Fi from hackers. However, in reality, it is not. However, there is a better option of some security rather than no security. In order to understand MAC in greater detail, let's take a simple example. Suppose user A and user B wants to communicate, and each of them has a mobile phone. So the simplest way for communication is by simply calling to the number of your friend that you want to call to. So in order for that condition to get fulfilled, there are two prerequisites. The first is each of those mobile phones should have a SIM card, and each SIM card should have a unique number associated with it. Two mobile phones with two SIM cards cannot have a same number. Each mobile phone number is always a unique one, and I hope you know this. This is similar to how communication between two computers takes place. So let us understand how a local computer communication takes place. So let's say this is computer A and this is computer B, and there are total 7 computers attached to a single network. So if a computer A wants to send a message to computer B, it has to make sure that that message should not be reached or be accessible by all the other computers except the computer B. This is similar to the mobile phone analogy. So suppose you send a SMS to a mobile B, your service provider should make sure that no other mobile number except that of the number of user B should be able to receive that message. So, in order to make sure that the message is being communicated to the right computer, there is a mobile number which is associated with each computer, and that mobile number is unique to each computer. And this mobile number is what we call as the MAC address. Now, MAC address is a unique 12-digit address, and it is unique to all the computers in the world. So let us understand the general format of MAC addresses. So MAC addresses generally consists of 12-digit hexadecimal number. The format is generally MM, 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 followed by SS, SS and SS. Now, the first 6 digit, which is MM, is reserved for the company's manufacturer number. So let's take an example. So this is the example of a MAC address of a particular computer. So here the first 3 spaces, which is 00, A0 and C9, corresponds to the 3 mm. Now this is a unique manufacturer number, so this number might be same for all the adapters based on a company, maybe say Intel. So if the adapter is designed by another company, let's say for example Realtek, then the mm portion will change. Each manufacturer has a unique portion associated with it. However, the SS portion is the serial number which changes. So, let's say for example, there are two computers with Intel-based NIC card. So, as it is an Intel, it will have the same digits. However, the SS digits of both the computers will change. So let us understand it in much more clearer way. So in the second column, you can see all the list of wireless networks that are available in the particular area. And corresponding to each wireless network, there is a corresponding MAC address associated with it. Always remember, each computer, laptop, tablet, mobile phone, even wireless router has a unique MAC address associated with it. So, let us consider an example of the first three IINC-based wireless network. Now, if you look into the MAC address portion associated with the first three Wi-Fi network, we see that there is a common portion. That is 5C, 50 and 15 is same for all the three Wi-Fi network. So from this we can conclude that all the three routers are from the same manufacturer because the manufacturer ID is same. However, if we look into the serial number, each of them has a unique and different serial number. First one ends with 71, followed by 7E, followed by 7F. That means if we want to communicate with IN, we can send message on this unique number. And the networking will make sure that this message won't be delivered to the second address because the last bit is different. Similarly, if we consider IINC with Mento, here we can see that the first three columns 5C, 50 and 15 is different from that of 68BC and OC. That means these two Wi-Fi networks are designed from different manufacturer, and that is why they have a different portion associated with it. So how can I find the MAC address of my particular computer? So before we do that, let's understand and dig bit more into this picture. So here you can see I have a wireless LAN adapter. The manufacturer is Atheros and there is a unique portion associated with it. Now if you would have a wireless card with same manufacturer, you will have similar portion. However, the SS portion will be different. Similarly, there is a different company called Realtek. And if you look into the portion of the Realtek manufacturer, it is different from that of Qualcomm. So let us see how we can find our MAC address of our own computer. So I'll minimize the slide. Go to run, type in cmd. You'll find a command prompt and type ipconfig slash all. And you'll be presented with a big list. Now I'm not going to scroll throughout the list, but here you can see I have a VMware virtual Ethernet adapter, and corresponding to this there is a section called as physical address, and there is a unique address associated with it, and this is what we can call it as MAC address. This address is unique to each computer. That means the same address which I have, you will not have the same one. So let us come back to our slides. So I hope you have understood the basics of why MAC addresses are used. As I said earlier also, most of the companies who are using Wi-Fi in their premises, they use MAC-based control list to protect their Wi-Fi networks. Now, in order to understand why there is a MAC-based filtering, let's take a simple example of mobile phone again. So let's say I am a user A and I have a friend called user B. Now, user B is calling me repeatedly on my mobile phone and I'm really upset with it. Now, I do not want to pick up the call of that user B. So what will I do? I'll simply install an application that will block the number of user B. So whenever user B will try to call me, the application will automatically block the call. And it is as simple as that. Similar analogy is used as far as Wi-Fi security is concerned. So let us understand this example. So I have 6 different computers. Each computer has a unique MAC address associated with it. Now, take for example a university campus. So you have a school and school has the Wi-Fi router. And everyone, by that I mean each student as well as teachers, knows the password of that wireless router. So the first 3 computers are that of teachers and the next 3 computers are that of students. So as a wireless administrator, how can I block students from accessing my Wi-Fi even though they know my Wi-Fi's password, right? So that means even though student knows my Wi-Fi password, still they should not be able to connect to my Wi-Fi. And this is exactly where MAC-based filtering is used. So what happens is in MAC-based filtering is I'll tell my router that any device with this, this, and this MAC address tries to connect to my Wi-Fi router, even though the password is right, block them. So, in simply any computer with the following 3 MAC addresses tries to connect to my Wi-Fi router, even with the right password, they won't be able to connect. I hope you got this simple analogy and we'll do this in practicals.